Holy Spirit, and today we begin looking at the gifts of the Holy Spirit. The gifts of the Holy Spirit. The gifts of the Holy Spirit. Let's turn to 1 Corinthians, the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Let's turn to 1 Corinthians, chapter 8. Sorry, 1 Corinthians chapter 12. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 8 to 12. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 8. We'll read up to verse 12. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 8. For to one is given the word of wisdom through the Spirit, to another the word of knowledge through the same Spirit, to another faith by the same Spirit, to another gifts of healings by the same Spirit, to another the working of miracles, to another prophecy, to another discerning of spirits, to another different kinds of tongues, to another the interpretation of tongues. We can finish with verse 11. But one and the same Spirit works all these things, distributing to each one individually as He wills. That last part is very important. As He wills. From the Amplified Version, to one is given in and through the Holy Spirit the power to speak a message of wisdom, and to another the power to express a word of knowledge and understanding according to the same Holy Spirit. To one, to another, wonder working faith by the same Holy Spirit. To another, the extraordinary powers of healing by the one Spirit. To another, the working of miracles. To another, prophetic insight, the gift of interpreting the divine will and purpose. To another, the ability to discern and to distinguish between the utterances of true spirits and false ones. To another, various kinds of unknown tongues. To another, the ability to interpret such tongues. Verse 11. All these gifts, achievements, abilities are inspired and brought to pass by one and the same Holy Spirit, who apportions to each person individually exactly as He chooses. It is the Holy Spirit who chooses, who wills and decides what to give to us. It is very important for us to know, as we look at this topic on the Holy Spirit, and as we look at these gifts, each and every one of these gifts, it is given to benefit the body of Jesus Christ, not an individual. The body of Jesus Christ. The gifts are for the body. And in this, again, we see the Trinity of God working together in unity as far as the body of Jesus Christ is concerned. I hope you're right. We see in this chapter the Holy Trinity of God, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit working together in unity for the sake of the body of Jesus Christ, the church. Or the church, the body of Jesus Christ. When we look at verse 4 of this chapter, when we look at verse 4 of this chapter, we see God the Father. We see the Holy Spirit being mentioned. Verse 4 and verse 5, they present to us God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. What they give for the building and for the benefit of the church, the body of Jesus Christ. Verse 4 says, there are diversities of gifts, but the same Holy Spirit. Please help us with Amplify so that we are able to maximize on time. Amplify. Now, there are distinctive varieties and distribution of endowment, gifts, extraordinary power, powers distinguishing certain Christians. This is now the explanation of what the gifts are. These are endowments that the Holy Spirit distributes. It is the Holy Spirit who gives the gifts. It is the Holy Spirit who gives the gifts. And He gives them or distributes them as He chooses or as He wills. It is His prerogative who He will give which gift. He's the one who decides. He's the one who chooses. Even though the Bible tells us to desire the gifts, but the choice and the decision and the will of who will get what belongs to the Holy Spirit. We can desire and miss. Because He is the one who chooses who to give which gift. So He gives, and every gift is unique. It is distinctive. It is unique by itself and to the person that is given the gift. And this is not one gift. There are varieties. There are different gifts. And the Holy Spirit distributes them. He endures, He empowers, He gives these extraordinary powers to distinguish certain Christians. So the gifts will be known. You will be distinguished according to the gift that the Spirit has given to you. It will identify you. It will identify you. Due to the power of divine grace operating in their souls, this gift, this endowment, this power is given to somebody, to a Christian. And due to the power of divine grace, not merit, this grace, you can't work to receive a certain gift of the Holy Spirit. It doesn't matter how much you put your human labor. It is by grace. Due to the power of divine grace operating in their souls. Whose souls? The Christians. The souls of the Christians. By the Holy Spirit. So this gift can be distinguished through the divine power that is operating by the grace of God through the Holy Spirit in the life, or in your life, or in the life of a believer. This gift can be distinguished. It is not what the witch doctors are doing, advertising themselves. And you find things pasted on billers pasted on posts. They are saying of the power that they carry. No. The one from God. The power itself and the operation of the Holy Spirit through and in your soul, it will be known. The gift will be distinguished. The gift will be known. The gift will be recognized. You don't need to advertise yourself. And the gift will be known through the operating power of the divine Holy Spirit who works through your soul or from your soul. And they vary, these gifts vary, but the Holy Spirit remains the same. The gifts vary, but the Holy Spirit remains the same. He works in and through every gift. That is the Holy Spirit. Verse 5. So the Holy Spirit gives gifts as He chooses. He gives gifts. Verse 5. And there are distinctive varieties of services or operations, according to King James Version, operations. Distinctive varieties of services and ministration. But it is the same Lord who is served. Here we see Jesus. Let's finish and then I will continue. And there are distinctive varieties of operations, of working to accomplish things. But it is the same God who inspires and energizes them all in all. So we see God. God gives the operations. Jesus releases the services, and the Holy Spirit releases the gifts. So the Holy Spirit gives gifts, and Jesus creates offices where these gifts will operate, and supervision of these gifts, so that when the gift is serving, it is serving in a certain office. Are we together? The Holy Spirit gives gifts. Jesus gives the offices in which these gifts are supposed to operate. And then God creates the environment where these gifts will be operating and working. So we find God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And in this, we find God in His Trinity, Holy Trinity, is giving the gifts, is giving the offices, and is giving the operations, the field in which the gifts will operate. They work together in unity. So one cannot have a gift, and there is nowhere that gift should operate. They stay in a house in Kalambwala for you to go. No. There must be an environment where that gift is supposed to work, and that gift is supposed to work within the body. Not at a corner somewhere that people flock there. It is supposed to work within the body. These gifts are given, and these ministries are given. Please help us with the King James Version that most of us are familiar with. These gifts, these ministries, and these operations are supposed to take place in the body. They have been given so that the body of Jesus Christ can be edified. and can be strengthened. And there are diversities of activities, but it is the same God who works all in all. Verse 5. There are differences of ministries, but the same Lord. Whether it is the ministry of a prophet, it's the ministry of an apostle, it's a ministry of an evangelist, a pastor. All these ministries, even though they are different, but they are serving the same Lord. And Jesus gave, that's right, Jesus gave to the church. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 11. He gave the ministries, the offices where these gifts are supposed to operate. And these offices are called governmental. These ministries are called governmental ministries. There are two types of ministries. Now, those who do not come for leadership seminar, let me borrow something and bring it to this. There are two types of ministries. There is a governmental ministry, and there is what? A congregational ministry. The governmental ministries are these fivefold ministries. And what are their role? To oversee the services of the congregational ministries. That will help you to understand what Amplified Version speaks about in this verse. The services that are offered are overseen by these offices. These are offices. The office of an apostle, the office of a prophet, the office of an evangelist, the office of a teacher, the office of a pastor. They are to oversee the services that is offered and that is done, carried out in the body of Jesus. So the services are part of the ministry. And how is the ministry done? The ministry is done by the gift. When the gift begins to operate, as the God Almighty gives it power to operate in the environment that is supposed to operate, what the gift does is called ministry. And as the gift ministers to people, God is being served and God is being glorified. Are we together? So we cannot have gifts and these gifts are not under a ministry. And we cannot do ministry unless God has empowered that gift so that it can operate. So the Holy Spirit gives gifts. Jesus provided offices and oversight offices for these gifts to do service. Service to God as human beings are being ministered to by the gift. So, God the Father creates the field. God the Son releases the offices. God the Holy Spirit releases the gifts. When each gift is working, it is providing a certain service. And that service is called ministry. And when that gift is ministering, the Lord is glorified and people receive what God is releasing through that. And God inspires this so that He is the one who is in charge of everything. So we have the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit working to provide to the body of Jesus Christ, the church, what the church needs, so that the church can be built, can be edified, to grow to the stature of reaching the fullness of the stature of Jesus Christ. It is very important for you to know you are all in the body of Jesus Christ. The Holy Spirit gives various gifts. Jesus releases the offices that will oversee and facilitate those gifts to work in the body of Jesus Christ. And then God releases the field, or gives the field of operation, and inspires those gifts so that they are able to minister to us. So if somebody has a gift and they are hiding it in a certain village somewhere, it is not for the village, it's for the group. It is for the church. It is wrong. It is a misappropriation of the gift to stay in the house instead of that gift operating in the church. The body, where the body of Jesus Christ meets. This is where these gifts are supposed to be working. And there is an oversight of those gifts. Every congregational ministry is supposed to operate under the governmental ministry. I hope you understand. Every congregational ministry. And you know, the congregational ministry are dependent upon the gift that is given to that person in the congregation. That gift is supposed to work within the church where there is oversight of the governmental ministry. But we have seen people using those gifts as they stay in the house. It doesn't go that way. It doesn't go that way. So, the Holy Spirit gives gifts. Jesus gives the offices for the services. God the Father enables these gifts to do certain operation in the body of Jesus Christ. We come to verse 8. And because of time, I will introduce and we will dig deeper coming Sunday, God enabling us. Now, when we come to verse 8, that we have looked at the gifts of the Spirit, the gifts of the Holy Spirit, these gifts refer to spiritual capacities. Spiritual capacities that are given to Christians. This endowment that the Holy Spirit gives to Christians. And He is the one who works through the Christians by the power He releases. And this is all by grace. It's not because of how good we are in a certain field. It's not because of how good we are able to operate. It is not a merit. It's by grace. So the Holy Spirit releases this power through the soul, or in the soul of a Christian, believe in Christ. And the Holy Spirit begins to operate in this gift the way He wants the gift to operate. So these are capacities given to us as God's people to strengthen the body of Jesus Christ and the people of God. So the gift is not about us. The gift is not for us. The gift still belongs to God. Even if it has been given to us, it is still belonging to God. That's why we shall give an account to God. So the gift is not ours for us to use it the way we want. To use it when we feel like using it, not to use it when we feel like not using it. To use it for our selfish gain. To use it to make names for ourselves. No. The gift is not for us. The gift belongs to God. And it's supposed to glorify God as it serves God's people and strengthen God's people. We have three classifications of gifts. The gifts of the Holy Spirit are classified in three divisions or classes. These are A. First of all, let's write proper notes. Number one, Roman numeral number one. Divisions or classifications of the gift of the Spirit. Divisions or classification of the gifts of the Holy Spirit. So there are three divisions. The gifts of the Holy Spirit are divided into three classes. A. Gifts of revelation. A. Gifts of revelation, also known as mind gifts. B. Gifts of inspiration. Gifts of inspiration, also known as vocal gifts. Vocal gifts. And C, the third class, gifts of power. Gifts of power, also known as working gifts. Also known as working gifts. So the gifts that we have read in 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 8 through to verse 11, but the gifts are through to verse 10. These gifts can be divided into three classes. There is the first class of the gifts of revelation. Gifts of revelation. The mind gifts. This is what God reveals. And then we have the second category of the gifts, which are gifts of inspiration. The gifts of speaking. Vocal gifts, the gifts of speaking, something coming forth. And lastly, the gifts of power, the gifts of power. Now these are the working gifts which people really like to identify. This is where healings, miracles, and people don't want the gifts that are silent. People want the gifts that are shouting. If they are showing who they are. And we will do that coming Sunday. We will look at the first class of the gifts of revelation. Because if we start now, we will not finish. The gift that you have can be put in one of these three divisions. The gifts that the Holy Spirit has given to us, they are in one of these revelations. And sometimes we are tempted to do what we are not supposed to do, or to use a certain gift in a certain division which does not, the gift does not belong to that division. Unless these gifts have been given to us and the service is needed, then the gift will operate according to the service that is needed and according to the gift that has been given to you. But some, we are not satisfied because we have this gift which belongs to this class. We want to operate in another class that we don't have the gift for it. And that's where things go wrong. That's where things go wrong. If we can stick to where we are supposed to operate, if we can stick to the gift and to the service that this gift is supposed to give, then the entire body of Jesus Christ will be strengthened. And the people will be fortified. But the problem is, the eye wants to do the work of the toe. Oh, you see, I am part of the body. I am seeing, so I can also walk. No, you are not the leg. Accept to be the eye. And the leg accept to be the leg. And the stomach accept to be the stomach. When every part, because every part of our body do what they are supposed to do, then the body remains strong. But when the leg wants to be on top of the head, it can't. It can't think. The leg cannot think. And because of misplacement of gifts, I'm taking a certain route which will take us far if I continue. But know this, human beings can misplace the gifts. You are this, you are blessed to be something else, or blessed in another office, in another environment where the gift is not supposed to operate. That gift will remain dormant. Until when it is in the right environment to provide the service that is supposed to provide. Sometimes we bless ourselves. God wants us, God has created the environment is this, but God, I don't want this environment, I want this one. So we position ourselves wrongly. And the truth is, because I'm supposed to speak the truth, and nothing but the truth is, the gift will not give the service that it's supposed to give until it has been brought back to the right environment. Why accept to be misplaced with the gifts that they have? Money, number two, prestige. Money and prestige. These are two things that are killing the gifts so that they do not do what they are supposed to. They do not give the service they are supposed to. In the Bible, there is one person, there is one family that took a priest for their own family. And this priest was told, we will give you food. We will give you a place to stay. We will pay you. But become our family. The priest is supposed to serve in the temple. or in the tabernacle, and he became a family priest, not in the tabernacle, not in the temple, but in a house of the Sabbath. The gift was misplaced. Why did he accept the gift to be misplaced? Money. And that position. We need to be very careful. We need to be very careful. And these gifts are different. Now, allow me to close that so that because I will continue. These gifts. When we talk about the gift of faith, it is different from the measure of faith that you have been given. Every one of us has been given a measure of faith. But there is somebody that has been given a gift of extraordinary faith. But every one of us has a measure of faith. So that is different. Every one of us has a measure of faith, but there is a gift of faith. Every one of us has been given power to lay hands on the sick, and the sick will be healed. But there is a gift of healing. We should differentiate these things. Every one of us baptized with the Holy Spirit, you can speak in tongues as the Holy Spirit gives you utterance. But there is a gift of tongues. Are we together? We should not confuse this. There is a gift of tongues. Every person, as the Holy Spirit gives utterance, can speak in different languages as the Holy Spirit enables it. But there is a gift of tongues. Different from what every other person has been given. And those are the tongues that are supposed to be interpreted. It is not when you are in prayer and the Holy Spirit gives you a language to talk to the Father. That one does not need interpretation. God understands the language. He doesn't need an interpreter. But when God speaks to us in a language we do not understand, we need an interpreter. That's why there is also a gift of interpretation of tongues. It is that gift is not to interpret every time. It is to interpret the message given to us in a different language that we do not understand. Another caution before we get into this topic. Just because God wanted to speak to us today, and maybe the person who has the gift of prophecy is not around, God can use it. But that does not make you a prophet. So there is a one time that something, God, you are the one who is ready, you are the one who is available, you are the one who is ready to speak. And God gives you. We need to be very careful. We need to be very careful. If it is a gift, it is consistent. If it is a gift, it is. If it's a gift, it is. If it's a gift, it is. It is consistent. And God can speak to us. A prophetic message comes, and God speaks to us. And we hear. And none of us is, has an interpretation. God can pick somebody to interpret. That does not mean that that person has a gift of interpretation of tongues. It may have been for that one time. Are we together? Are we together? And sometimes we confuse this. The one time. And from that one time, we start declaring ourselves what the gift has done. And we don't have the gift. It was for the occasion. It was for the did King Saul become a prophet? But did he prophesy?
Yes.
Was he a prophet? It was occasional. It was for that occasion. It was not a gift, it was for an occasion. It was for a sign, a certain sign. As Samuel had said, you will meet with this and you will prophesy. You will meet with this and you will prophesy. But that did not make Saul a prophet. We have to be very careful. We have to be very careful. Because sometimes we hinder God in what he wants to do. Because something is for the occasion, it is for that moment, and we run with it. And because of running with it, we start doing things that we have cooked ourselves. Oh, I prophesied the other time in that place, so what do I do? So that people can know that I can also prophesy. My friend, you cook a prophecy. You do what? Although this congregation has stayed for a long time without a prophetic word. So you book a prophecy. And the prophecy you read for us, John 3:16. It's already written. We prophecies are special messages. Prophecies are special messages from God, but they must agree with scripture. So these are questions that I thought we need to know at the time we are starting this journey. So that when you allow the Holy Spirit to reveal to you the gift, or when you seek him to reveal to you the gifts that he has given, there are those with more than one gift. There are those with one gift, those with more than one gift, two gifts, three gifts, as the Spirit of God chooses. We need to take precautions of this, and we need to understand. We will develop it further as we move. So that when we deal with a certain character, not character, but classification of gifts, then we will be able to know this is how they operate, and this is how they can be misplaced, and this is how people can usurp. We have people who usurp certain gifts and they don't have it. But it doesn't last long. You find things start happening that are not in line with how that gift is supposed to operate, because there is no grace in our souls released by the Holy Spirit for that gift to work. But every one of us here, you have a gift. Every one of us here. And that gift is not for sitting down. It's for doing something in the house of the Lord, so that the body can benefit and the body can be strong. And as the Spirit of God reveals these gifts to us, we should know they are not ours, they are for the body. And we should avail them to strengthen the body and to build the body of Jesus Christ, the church. There are some that are just for the local church. There are some that are for the universal church. It is very important for us to know this. And it is part for us to seek the Lord to know and to understand where this gift is. Because people will mislead you. Unless you're careful, People can mislead you. They can tell you this gift is international. So from that time you start looking for visas which you are not getting. I was told my gift is international. I was told my gift is international. The Lord. If that gift is international, the Bible says the gift of a man shall make room for him. You should not start running up on that place. The gift will make room. When it is needed internationally, you will go. But operate where you are. And we find people who prophesy once and they start looking for visas. I have a prophetic word for the US. I have a prophetic word for South Africa. Why don't you have a prophetic word for Garissa? Amen. So we have understood the Holy Spirit gives gifts, Jesus provides offices, and God the Father provided the field for the operation of those gifts. And there are classifications of the gift of the Holy Spirit, and there are three classifications. They are gifts of, they are here. They are gifts of revelation. These are mind gifts. They are gifts of inspiration. These are vocal gifts. And they are gifts of power. These are working gifts. And almost everybody was the last class. Even those who are for inspiration gifts, they wanted the backing of miracles. And sometimes they take and force people to do things that God has not done. If we can be contented and be faithful in the field, God is able to take us and to give us more gifts for the other field. Shall we stand as we pray? We were introducing the topic today. May the Lord help us. It is very important. This is not just a head knowledge thing. This is something practical. You need to start seeking the Lord to know what kind of a gift he has given to you. What kind of a gift he has given to you.